creativity, knowledge, and neurosis. Three components able to cohabit in a human being. The commonplace that art is a product of mental disorders is, to my opinion, a wrong idea. Art is the expression of a deep soul who developed with a mix of emotions and knowledge special contents to express. Mental disorders are, on the other side, an entrapment for the soul and act against the emotional and the intellectual freedom, which are the basic conditions for art to be created. The complexities at the origin of a mental disease can at the same time produce that deepness who becomes art as two alternative ways. Many great artists face their neurosis or even psychosis with the parts of their souls who remain free enough to feel and create. One of the crucial discussions when it comes to psychoanalysis and art is about the role of mental disorders in the creative power of artists. My opinion is that personality diseases are an obstacle to the talent, not an aid as usually considered. The artist himself, as any human being, risks to identify his creativity with his disease. My opinion is based on the fact that a personality disease is other than pain, sorrow, or disappointment. The letters are for sure part of the creativity as far as they are a free emotional flow, while personality diseases are obstacles to the inner freedom to feel and express emotions. Unfortunately, the majority of people cannot perceive this distinction, bearing their diseases as inexorable fate. We should imagine Munch's art as the expression of the parties of his personality that were not affected by his diseases, as the parties that fought against the diseases. Munch confirms this opinion with his own words. "I am of the opinion, however, that my art is not sick. When I paint, sickness and suffering are, on the contrary, a healthy resource." Freud said to mankind that we know very little about ourselves. Without a deep and extensive psychoanalytic treatment, the largest and most crucial parts of our personality remains hidden in the unconscious. Mahler's neurosis was the result of conflicts who remained unknown and unresolved in himself. This did not avoid him to develop his great talent as a musical composer, but maybe resulted in limitations to the full expression of his originality, as Mahler himself sustained. A part of his personality was assigned to deal with that unresolved conflicts.